Place, my God, you're awesome in this place, Abba Father. We give you praise, Lord. You're awesome in this place, my God. I thank you for this morning, Lord. I thank you for this afternoon, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Heavenly Father. I give you praise. I give you glory. I give you honor. When the praises go up, Lord, the glory comes down. Teach us how to worship you. Teach us how to praise your name. Teach us how to glorify your name, because you are awesome in this place. You are awesome in this place, my God. You're awesome in this place, Holy Spirit. Father, we come before you this morning. We come before you this afternoon. Come and speak to us, Lord. Come and speak to us, King of Glory. Come and speak to us, Heavenly Father. Lord, today is a Friday. It is the fifth day of the week. My Master, some people, their week has ended. Some people are still going to go to work tomorrow. Some people, the weekend is already here. My Master, I dedicate today into your hands. Come and speak to us. Come and glorify yourself today, Lord. Father, I decrease as you increase. Come and speak through me, because I am just a vessel. I do not know how to speak. I do not know how to present myself. I do not know how to use the right words. But Father, with you, Lord, with you, my Master, anoint my lips. Lord, anoint my lips and use me for the glory of your name. For when the praises go up, the glory comes down. Teach us how to speak. Teach us how to speak, Lord. Teach us how to speak, my Master. Many of us do not know how to present ourselves, and we have really failed to understand that part because we are not discipled. But Father, this month, the month of discipleship, Lord, Father, we go back to the basics. Teach us your word. Teach us your word, Lord. Teach us your word, Lord. I welcome your Holy Spirit. I was stronger and Thank you, my God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are worthy, Lord. Lord, we need your grace. Uganda needs you more than ever before. Lord, the U.S., they need you more than ever before. Lord, it is only you who can fight this battle because it is more than human understanding. Oh, we need your grace, Lord. Come and fight for us, Lord. Come and fight for us, Lord. We need your grace. For the battle belongs to you. The battle belongs to you, Lord. The battle belongs to you, Father. The battle belongs to you, Lord. The battle belongs to you. Oh, the battle belongs to you, Lord. We need you, Lord. Need your grace, Lord. Need your grace, Lord. Need your grace, Lord. We need your grace, Lord. We need your grace, Lord. Speak to us and teach us what your grace is all about, because man's ideology has changed the grace into something so complicated and so weird to understand that people are just sinning through it. Oh, give us the right teachers for your word, Lord. Give us the right teachers to disciple us, Lord. Interpret for us, Holy Spirit, your word. Thank you, my God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Topitanga komulo kozi ngakuko owola ngabocha. Suna fo tu cha alire pa sminon to gentle savior, hear my humble cry while on others thou art called. By pass us on, Savior, hear our humble cry, while on others thou art calling. Do not pass. Jangu gwe moyo. Jangu gwe moyo yita mulamu wange. Ndyoke pumule ngadi ku bigere byo yita mubulamu wange. Hey, sweep over my soul. Sweep over my soul, sweet spirit, sweep over my soul, sweep over our souls, Lord. Sweep over our souls, Lord. Cleanse us, Holy Spirit, and take us back to the altar. Take us back to that place. That place where we got saved from. Take us back to the first love for Jesus. To the right place, to the first love. Father, take us back to that place. Many of us, we've gotten so used to the things of God that we do our own things. Because we are too used. Some, because they hear God speak, they have reached that level. God can speak anytime, anyhow. That we have reached to a level of defiling ourselves. Because we are used with the things of God and we just do things the way we want. That it gets so complicated when someone comes in to say, "My dear Esther, that is not how it is. The Bible says." And you're like, "My pastor, my prophet, my vision bearer said, I said, my woman of God, my man of God, I tell you, the one in charge here, I hear the one in charge in my house said, oh Lord, forgive us." And we have left the one in charge of the world. We have left the one in charge of earth. The one who said, "Let there be light. Let there be." And the Spirit of God hovered. Lord, help us and forgive us. I welcome you, Holy Spirit. Come and teach us your word. In Jesus' mighty name, I believe and pray. Amen and amen. Good afternoon, Uganda. Good afternoon, Africa. Good morning, the US. Good morning, Canada. Good evening, Asia. Good evening, China. China, the biggest manufacturer in the world. We love you, China. We love you, Europe. I, Esther, I love. Hello, Mukasa. Hope you are fine. It's been a while. We are here again, devotion time. Tag a friend to tag a friend, invite a friend. Do a watch party. Say yeah, please. What are you talking about? Say yeah, there. Today I decided to teach with my parents. I decided to teach with my family members, so I sit them here. Let me read for you something before I go into the word. No, I'll bring it later. Today's devotion is disciples and discipline. Open your Bible. You are a disciple. You say you are a disciple, but how disciplined are you? Do you know what the word discipline means? you've all gone to school in one way or the other, or your parents have tried to do something like that. Discipline. First, are you a disciple? Who is a disciple? If you start following, you become a disciple, right? Let us find out. But it's as simple as it is. In school, they teach you discipline. They tell you, in this school, we wear a uniform. You're supposed to tuck in. When I go to the prestigious school, Mango Senior School, the prestigious school, Celtic Academy, the prestigious school, Jim Cat Kindergarten, the prestigious school. The prestigious university, Chambok University. Chitavide Amori Primary School, the prestigious school. You're supposed to wear your uniform right. If you are a school that wears a belt, you're supposed to tuck in and put on your belt. You're supposed to wear your socks. For the boys, they were always gray in color. Some schools, the band was blue and white. And the socks were supposed to be, the stockings were supposed to be gray in color. Even when I went to Mango, it changed to yellow and red, kind of then gray. Luvidi had blue and red, white. My primary school had blue and white. Celtic Academy, we were wearing white. Even Mango, the girls, it was white. For the boys, the gray. Celtic, I used to wear a green skirt. I would tuck in when I became a prefect of time management. I wore the long-sleeved shirt. And I had a tie, striped, green in color. And I was supposed to be disciplined to be an example. Because I was on the prefectorial body. Even when I was my old level, Mango Senior School, I was a counselor. It is not just in a bone. I even took it close at school. When I was in my primary school, I was the religious leader. Don't joke around. No, I was the type, I don't like disobeying instructions. When they say don't go through the grass, when you're called, that is trouble. I made sure I followed the longer route. Do you know what happened when Moses followed the longer route? The burning bush. Everything starts in the spirit. But you want shortcuts all the time. Ayamba, yayamba. Let's enjoy the class. All the years you've done ayamba, yayamba, what have you done? What do you have? Especially in COVID-19. You're also crying, I don't have money. I don't have food. All the years you've been doing ayamba, yayamba, what happened? It all vanished? And rich people, you're too stingy. I've never seen this. When you never have all the time. Rich people, all the time you don't have. Rich people are also begging so that they support their projects. And I'm like, I thought you guys are rich. What happened? It is because your things are not permanent. There is a lot of compromise. You don't have discipline at all. When you start a life of compromise, you'll never have enough. This body you see keeps on wanting. Every single day you want something. It is because you fail to tame your own small temple. Now, how are you going to tame another temple with 70 of us? When you yourself, your own small temple has failed you. I just see groups and people cannot even control themselves. What they did, those who cannot control themselves, they just keep quiet and sit in Kamala and complain from there. And I'm like, okay, where are we going with this? They just beg you, Banange Kati, we have this project, please. No one answers, they all look. And when it comes to money, a group admin was singing. When it comes to money, everyone keeps quiet. was like, this is it. Everyone keeps quiet. And some group admins don't even put a penny, but they are good at collecting money. Very few give the truth. Accountability. Hey, my friends, you as the group leader, you're supposed to be the biggest example ever. If the highest on your group gives 50K, my friend, you double it and give 100 and bridge the gap. You already see Pastor Robert saying, you've given 90. Then he's like, I will top up. The man leaves the pulpit when he has topped up for 20 people. Yet he also gave his own. We still have a long way to go. Some of you are there. I want to be Pastor Robert one day. And I look at you and I'm like, will you pay the price? Do you think it just comes automatic? He was called and chosen. There is calling and you're not chosen. Don't confuse the two. Not everyone who is called is chosen for the season. We are not changing the topic. We are continuing with Samson. When a pastor attacks Samson, he attacks him different. When an apostle does the same, it is different. The Holy Spirit is very amazing. Open your Bibles. Tomorrow we are coming back, children. And we are continuing with the same character. Because you need to understand whether you were chosen, called, call it whatever you want. And we want to find out how do you behave. And why is it that all the time sin had to... Uganda. They have very interesting insights in the Bible. You've not yet discovered because for you, you just marathon through the Bible. And you have decided to kick out the Holy Spirit because your temple is not pure. You don't even bother to pursue righteousness. Disciples and discipline. Open your Bibles in 2 Corinthians. Oh, sweetheart Joel. It is Colossians. There is no 2 Corinthians. That is why I had to ask what it was. That is Esther for you. Please, parents and other people, when your friends are teaching and they give a scripture, please go ahead and look for it in the Bible. We are not angels. Then you type it there for them, please, especially for those who are watching. Because I'll give you a scripture, I give the right word, but the wrong scripture. If you know the right scripture, please type it there. And help those who don't read the Bible. Thank you plenty. This goes to everyone. Even big people make mistakes. They confuse the scriptures like this. So it is your responsibility to go and check out that scripture. See what he's saying. Then you refer it to what the preacher or the teacher is saying. Then you write the right scripture there, helping those who are in the class that day. Please. And please, the young Joshuas and the PKs, get some time and sit and watch yourselves and make sure you correct all the mistakes. So that next time you come back away, no, and that helps us to go deeper in the word of God, too. There was a time I was like, why do I have to publish people? The Lord is like, yeah, one day, one time, when they sit and watch themselves, they'll see the mistakes they've made. Please, young Joshuas and the PKs, go back, take some time off. Close yourself in the bedroom and watch yourself. Someone took over God's place. They were on UBC. They were on an interview. The Lord moved with that interview. My God, the divine encounters I have saw you in the spirit. And the Lord is like, that is where that person fell. and took over my place. And now I am no longer with them. I am not in the business of pointing fingers. I know you feel it in your spirit and you know who I'm talking about. So be careful, young Joshuas and PKs, because it is rough this season. Don't you ever teach and just walk away. Go back and sit and watch yourself. I do that every day as a must. I shut out. The Lord was like, that is how they make mistakes. And most of them don't go back to correct them. Be careful out there. You can take it or leave it. At the end of the day, it's your relationship with Jesus. I'm just a message carrier. I'm a courier bringing your emails, your mail, your packages. It is now words. Now if we start to bring a package, I don't know what you'll do. Please go back and watch yourselves. Because the Moseses have made mistakes, my God. There are 7,000 that you guys cannot see. The Lord has decided to hide. When they start seeing in the spirit, I myself, I take off. I'm like, ha, now this one is going to see all the food I ate and everything I spoke. You go and sit on TV stations with those. I think don't stop even wasting your time with some media personnel. Because that person failed that day completely, and also, and the devil is a liar. And the person does not know that for them they think valikatu funga yesu ya weta kuolo wakula interview. Ezo interviews ya mtula nababana avatari mumu yu mtukufu wadi. Be careful. Yes, Satani aliwo, he's a target worker. He brings those boys and girls who know nothing about the Lord. And they put you in a spot. Now, if you're the type who is not humble, who has never humbled themselves, they wait for the season to humble them. Ah, chigwa kup. That video, the owner, go back and watch it. You will know what I'm talking about. 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse. Many of you have made mistakes. Sometimes I sit here and I wonder and I'm like, did this person... There is a time Apostle Chimoli said, most of you, first of all, you don't have the Holy Ghost. There is no presence at all. And you don't take time to prepare. Then you come and give only wrong things. Only wrong things. Leave some of us. Today I wake up and I've been preparing and then the Lord hijacks and takes over and brings another message. We are different. That has ever happened. There is a time Apostle Bunjo came with another message and the Lord hijacked the service and brought another message and the Apostle looked like this. You could not even believe that the message had changed. That happens. But when the message changes and it's the Lord who has changed it, it just flows. Because you carry the presence. But most of you, the presence of the Lord left. You're dry. I'm sorry. It is the truth. You can look for me and punch me. I told you I don't work for man anymore. Young Joshua's and PK, be very careful. Kuwanga mwagalo utala. But you're carrying in the wrong places at the wrong time. Because you want to compete all the time. What we are going through is not a competition. You're playing with people's lives. And trust me, you will pay for it dearly. You joke around if you think it's time for joking and playing with people's lives. Simply because you want to keep a big number following you. And you're a very wrong disciple. The season we are in is not looking for fame. It is not about the big numbers. Who are you taking to heaven? If you yourself have any potato, now who are you going to take? Because you don't want to be discipled. When you're told the wrong things, then you put your nose, your mouth in the nose like this, then you start causing commotion. Now, you followers, if your leader is the commotion type, they love fighting, think twice when you're seated in that congregation. Because you're going to go to hell while looking like this. Some musicians don't have the presence of the Holy Spirit completed. They just have voices. It's because you're not sensitive in the spirit. That's why you cannot even agree at all. But we know you sit in a service and it's very dry and you're like, what am I doing here? Let's start from verse 11. Therefore, since we know the fear of the Lord and understand the importance of obedience and worship, we persuade people to be reconciled to Him. But we are plainly known to God. He knows everything about us. You know, you keep hiding. You hide the truth, you hide everything. But with that day, you're going to be undressed and we all see how naked you are. You see, everyone got to know how badly mannered I am. Like, mwanyambula and I'm naked completely. And me, I protected you. Because I stayed with the truth. But all other people know that I'm the one who is wrong. I accepted to take the fall so that you shine, wow, wow. Because if it starts with me, because me, I do something. For you, you come out because you're the fighting type. I'm like, since I am the one who started it, like, because everyone looks at it and I'm the one who started it, I'm like, since it started with me, it ends with me. I cease fire. Through, actually, the things I learned, most of you don't have the grace to take in particular things. I thought you were mature enough to handle the power with which some words come with. But now I know, not every intercessor you tell them things. Now I know who to tell what, when, and where. Because some of you, your lifestyle of an intercessor is for praying for your small families. Some it is for nations, some it is for praying for ministers. Now I know who to tell what, when, where. Some you're just supposed to pray for me, so there are things I cannot tell you. Every day I learn a thing or two. Because everyone has different anointing, different power to take in different things. Because I believe there are things I will tell Apostle Bunja and he will not even get surprised. He will not even quarrel. There are things I will tell Pastor Robert and he will not even quarrel. But there are some of you, someone says something and you just take off. Ngalukuocha. Be very careful if you want to be a disciple. When you're told something, you have to learn to know how to carry it. That's why some people will never tell you things, and never. That is why you're going to miss out on many things. Because you decided to allow the devil come into your life. And he's using you the way he wants. This tool, God created it to worship. To praise. If you are an intercessor, to warn, go and read your Bibles right. That is why there are those who were chosen and called for the season. Because some of you cannot handle that. You're not strong-hearted, you're faint-hearted. Continue. Discipline. Someone who is disciplined, you don't move around mansaring words. You sit down and you ask yourself, Apostle Chimuli's class, why? Lord, what are you saying? You have to look beyond the word you've just heard. You don't just hijack it. Because it is the devil who hijacks such things and confuses them. And before you know it, you look like a useless chicken when the head is cut off. Because when the head is cut off, the only thing anyway, it's still useless because it's going to go on the plate. That is how the devil makes us look like a chicken without a head. That is how you run around with your mouth. Don't you ever eat the food of a lumamonga. That is very, very dangerous. The devil is the father to the lumamongas. For him spreading a word, tachiruamu. That is why some of you are good at spreading the wrong information on social media. You don't save the information, you send them on WhatsApp. There is a time I told someone sent something on a particular group and I was still doing things, I got a sweetheart. Then I sent it to someone. Someone is like, Esther, are you sure? I'm like, I'm not yet sure, but I'll find out. I went and found out. And the thing was fake. And I went back and told these guys, be careful with forwards. Especially when someone says type amen, I hear, be very careful. There was something that came out. It was about Archbishop Duncan Williams. When I traced back to the source, Archbishop was denying it. And I'm like, Bambi, cut now. I don't know how many people received this message that it comes from Archbishop Duncan Williams. I did not just quarrel when I took it somewhere else and someone, because I was like, no, let me send it somewhere else and someone tells me. That is how I find out whether things are true or not. I did not quarrel with the person. Well, no, I did not. When they asked me, Esther, is that true? Please can, I'm like, I'm not so sure, but let me find out. Then I found out the truth and a person told me, I thought so. Because you sense in the spirit, sometimes you'll sense that it's wrong when it is right. You're not an angel. Stop forwarding things. I told you man's ideologies are very, very bad. Especially when it involves God, be careful with those things. You're going to send the wrong information around. That is how people... Weba te weba chama. I saw something on social media and I shared it. It was about Moses' wife. Someone interpreted it. Mbuno, Moses' wife gave, we should thank Moses' wife for giving her man space to serve the Lord. I looked and I'm like, okay. I shared it. Later I sat down and thought about it and I'm like, the Bible says that's a wise someone. We are not commending ourselves, verse 12, we are not commending ourselves to you again, but are giving you an occasion to be rightfully proud of us, so that you will have an answer for those who take pride in open bracket, outward, close of bracket, appearances, the virtues they pretended to have, rather than what is actually in heart. Most of us have decided to pretend, to live a life of pretense. Because you don't want to be ashamed. Like, you're like, what will people say? We are living the life of what will people say. Pastors have been seeing me that I pray. Now, how do they find out that me and my husband, we are having issues? How? The devil is hiding it so that you can rot more in your marriage. And outside you take pictures and we are all like, oh, Anangi, when I grow up, I want to be like you. Pure. Please stop lying to us. We want very good representatives in the marriage institute. Because you don't tell the truth, you start to live a life of pretense. Some of those boys are beating their wives. And the wife has to come and teach us. And the wife, whenever they teach, you just see bitterness flying around. And they're like, I'm somebody wrong as an engineer. Come. Kumbe mamuli dem pie chido. Atenga bawa to the wali wajirina kwa wali. Sitatia ya saha chinga. El chido mamuli dem. For crying out loud. Good morning, Esther Shamieta. Am I octagon that you are poor? Stop living a life of a lie. Borrowing things. Gallows. Especially those who are in school. I'll have an example for you some other time, children. I love originality. I am an independent person. Very independent. When someone told me that I'm tying myself on someone, I was like, oh. My name is Independency. I advocate for independency. For me to look for people and say hello is because I look beyond just having family members and friends. I don't call you because I want money from you. It is because your mindset is like, that girl is struggling, her parents are struggling. Whenever you see the call, Tata, I'm ready to hang out your center. Not me. Even when we didn't have, there was a time I reached a point and we told my mom never to call my dad's siblings ever again. We will take care of him with our God. Anti abamu wagamba chivonerezo. Katuchilie bulungi. Kasta, when we are shining, wawawa, those ends, you are proud of us. Discipline. Tuvalinze nga tufumbirwa. You think we would not? Oh, watch the space. Unless the Lord wrote it somewhere that for us, my father's house is not. But if the Lord has not written it anywhere, iron your gomeses and kanzas, my friends and family members. Manyedi ya wantu nga bobalo wo zapokawe batuka. Discipline. People who are rich, the way they speak, you're like, mzee, what do you say to langira? Like they talk to you as if Toby take it. And I have a bad habit. When I start hearing that whatever you're saying is, I switch off and just look at it. And I'm like, now this one has no clue of what they are talking about. Sometimes I don't want to hear people whose marriages have failed, whose relationships have failed so bad. I don't want to hear them talk when it comes to marriage and love, because they have nothing sweet to talk about men, especially the women. And even when you find a man who is hurt, all they bring out is poison. Number 13, if we are out of our mind, just unstable, fanatics, as some critics say, it is for God. If we are in our right mind, it is for your benefit. For the love of Christ controls and compels us, because we have concluded this, that one died for all, therefore all died. For your life, it is a me thing. Your love is a me thing. For God so loved the world that he gave. For Esther so loved the world that she first miss herself. May I love myself? If I don't love me, how will I love others? We love differently. If you're loving you is first taking care of your problems, that is you. When I love myself, I do things that make me happy by standing in the gap. That is how God created me. Ask those who know who the real Esther is. Don't ask those who run the mouth about Esther. They don't have anything sweet to say. When I love, when Bere nunga Isaac, I need chocolate, that makes my day. Why? Because I don't have, I wish. I don't like that part, I wish. They tell you, Banange, someone is sick. You all sit and look in the group. Someone has no food. You all keep quiet and look at each other like this. There was a time someone died, the husband died. I did not say anything. They asked people to get money. I just kept quiet. I went to the inbox, Nenumba. omunene kubanene. And we talked. What was so surprising? Omunene kubanene yali mulwadde. Ne mugamba omanyi? Anti oli yafudde. Ate gwe kyali mulamu. Katujanjabe gwe. Ne tujanjaba omunene. Ne ngamba kasita bali baweereza amabugo ago gagende nze kanzijanjaba omunene. Kubanga to omunene mwetaaga nnyo. Omufu si kyalina kye mwetaaza. Bali abali ku ground kabagende balabe omufu. Bamukonsolinga. Simanya baba agenda. Omanyi tulina habit ey'okuwandika ebintu group. But action zero. Love without action is dead. Discipline. Discipline also. You have to be disciplined. You don't just have to say things when you don't act at all. There is no discipline in there. You're supposed to be a man and woman of your word. You say we are going to visit so and so. Don't just talk about it. Go. Go. And don't do it to make other people, to make a statement. Let it come from the bottom of your heart. I told you guys, don't feel sorry or pity for me when you don't love me genuinely. It doesn't make sense for me. I don't work with pretenders. That is why I told you guys who are doing challenge of the I hear for those who are mentally disabled, please, the intention of your heart, not outside and videotaping your waserefu, those two are different. Because you have no idea what it means to lose your mind. When everyone looks at you and all they see is someone who has lost it. Most of the times when our friends lose it, all we do is talk about them. My friend died last year and it was on my birthday when they committed suicide. And words moved around. Esther, when I went into investigation, let's continue the word of God. For if we are out of our mind, just unstable, fanatics are, as some critics say, it is for God. If we are in our right mind, it is for your benefit. For the love of Christ controls and compels us, because we have concluded this, that one died for all. Therefore all died, and he died for all, so that all those who live would no longer live for themselves, but for him who died and was raised for their sake. Verse 16. So from now on, we regard no one from a human point of view according to worldly standards and values. Though we have known Christ from a human point of view, now we no longer know him in this way. Because you know that Jesus came and became flesh, some of us got to know Christ that way. That is why the Pharisees never got a point. Because they were like, sure, a mere man. It is the same thing even these days. That's why I keep telling you, church, be very careful. Especially with the EMP. You don't watch Apostle Bunjo because you respect only Pastor Robert is the one you honor. And you don't know how to honor. That is the other part of the story. When you honor Pastor Robert, you just put him in God's position. In that for you, unless he puts a hand on you, that is the only time Jesus will heal you. It is because you put Pastor Robert in God's place. That's how why you see it that way. But the way God has healed me when I'm not with people at home, your mindset. When my message change was confirmed for yesterday, it's a child that prayed for me and the Lord confirmed the message. I am the type who respects anointing. When the child prayed, I did not hear the child. I heard God speak. And the message, it is because how do you respect the anointing upon? That anointing is not theirs, it is for God. But for you, you honor man, woman, God. But you miss the point of he who gives the anointing. That is why for you when you say, I am, Manoa. Because you don't know how God speaks. You only know how Pastor Robert speaks. You only know how Apostle Wunja speaks. You only know how Apostle Chimuli speaks. You only know how Dr. Mulinde speaks. You only know how Dr. Reverend Musa speaks. You only know how Pastor Tom speaks. You only know how Pastor Ben Ochola speaks. You only know how Pastor Mark speaks. You only know how Never Give speaks. You only know, yeah, tell those who hang around Archbishop Duncan Williams, they even in need. Don't joke. Men and women in need. Let me hope they kneel for God behind. You know, when you're moving like this, God is moving from your back. Protect your back. The army uniform. Because if you move with righteousness here, God doesn't need to be here. When righteousness is here, you're covered. And by the time you start moving like this, God has already seen where you're going. There are places where he's moving with you from the back. There are times he carries you. How is he going to carry you when he's at the front? He's a God who knows everything. He carries you because sometimes you cannot move when he puts men on the eagle's wings. Continue. Go back to verse 14. For the love of Christ controls and compels us. Your love, I don't know, my friends, I don't know. That love of yours is just on another level. Because there's a time I sat down and I'm like, how can you wake up and tell me you love me? Then tomorrow it is a bitter pill. Tomorrow you abuse me and you say a lot of words. What kind of love is that? Today I'm a sweetheart. Tomorrow, you don't want to look at me. When you're saying things about me, you don't even think about my parents. You don't think about my name. You don't think about the picture you're leaving in front of people about me. You don't think about my reputation. You don't. Because you're selfish. All you want is for you to be up there. That's why I told you, you are a giant. All you've done is to walk on the generous ground. You stepped on me because I'm known. I'm a someone. It is not my fault. I went to the right schools. Everyone knows me. Like, if you've been to Mengo 1998 to 2001, I am known. Unless if you never went to the assembly ground. That short girl with big specs, when I just move out like this, everyone knows me. The teachers know me. Because the late Ganap Sanga decided I should sing as the anthem every day. The day he left me on the ring road, and then he reached the university at the school, and I made sure I ran, I took off. Don't ask me how I got there. And when he stepped on like this, I was standing at the back. And he's like, Tero Nachimera, to get a school near her home. I'm like, this man stays in the other side of Namaya. We use the same route. He cannot carry me on the school truck. And people laughed at me, those who were standing near me. If you went through Mengo during that time, you know me. If I get my signature glasses, they are left it with my parents. Now for you, you just come and mingle with a reputation. Those I studied with know me. Those that I studied with direct. Those that I sang with in the scripture union. Because as the type, I was everywhere. Me, when I can do something, I go in, I don't care. That is Esther. I did not know it was the scripture my father gave me in 1998 on the 26th of February. Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and verse 10. Because for us, that is how Father gives the presents. I finished my P7, I got my 7.7. And he had told me they call you on merit.
Me, I went to Mengo on merit. I missed Dayaza because I don't remember it being my first choice, but I have a relative there. They wanted to take me to Gayaza in S1, and when they went there, there was no more space. The Lord never wanted me to go to Gayaza. But when the Gayazians, the Giza girls come out, I am well represented. Don't joke with us. When the Budonians walk out, I am well represented. When Chivuri comes out, don't play around. When Namaskali comes out, when Lubiri comes out, Kabinja boys, what are you talking about? Makonzi, Chitovu, those are schools we go to. Makere College, what are you talking about? Discipline, and all of them are disciplined in one way or the other. I don't care what story you have about my family members. I don't care, because the last time I checked, when I look at you like this, what kind of love is that that you have the guts? And you also are a teacher of the word. We need teachers. We pray so that the Lord over to syndicate over angel to gende nabo. Kubanga, what man has done, I myself, I cannot tell it all. How can you, a full pastor, no tulamo interview, no daku pastor, tulimu COVID era bachali eyo balekana, and I'm like, kayanja ali yabasente, tulimu COVID abantu bavu. What have you done apart from sitting with those useless media personnel? Do you know the biggest feeder, if that is the word I can use, the biggest house that has given food in the entire country? Do you know where it comes from? Those who are speaking a lot of words have not seen a thing you're doing. If you've done it, it's in your community. When someone can do things more than you can do, don't you ever open your mouth because you're not disciplined. Don't you ever. Politicians, if your job is to speak and badmouth others, in COVID-19, you will get corona with that mouth because it has no mask. Make sure you wear your mask, because when you put your mask, we cannot hear that much. We'll be like, what are they talking about? You people who have projects, and your job is to badmouth your competitor, be careful. As you talk bad about your competitor, the Lord is sending the customers to your competitor. Your job will be to sit there and eat in jugu the whole day when no one has branched off to buy the vlega you're selling. I told you, the game of bad mouthing and blaming game is not very good. That is how you guys are going to lose the positions. Just like that. You call press and bad mouth the president. Then you cry he's disrespecting you. It is because in the first place you never respected yourself. When I look at all of you who want to hijack that place, I'm going to read for you something. It does continue and finish. Discipline. Oh my God. You're full of the word. But when I look at the character, ill. Because someone who knows the Lord, there are things I don't expect. And the people around you are too blind to see the truth and what is not the truth. Because you decided, when you are a leader, you influence very, very. That is why those pyramids love leaders. Because when they hijack the leader like this, they have the entire pack. Whatever they say is what they do, because you honor. The devil is a liar. Do you know why some churches call Pastor Robert when they have a project? He has the anointing for money. When he stands on the pulpit like this, people just give because of the anointing. He is called and chosen. Now you're just called but are not chosen. And God is amazing. Did you attend Dr. Melinda's class yesterday? You did not? Okay. Look for it. It is on my wall. So from now on, we regard no one from a human point of view, according to worldly standards and values. Though we have known Christ from a human point of view, now we no longer know him in this way. Therefore, if anyone is Christ, that is grafted in, joined to him by faith. That is our scripture for, what do I call it? Okay, our point of celebration today. Dr. Melinda said something before I continue. He asked the Lord, couldn't you? There are men who are bigger than me. Why me? With God, he does not. When I look at all the men that are called and chosen, their background has man never recognized them back in the day. Never. When I look at their school life of man, it is a sad. The highest level of education, most of them, is Essex. But our generation, there's a time I talked to one of my fathers when I was struggling. I told him, Tata, the mistakes that were made during your time with my father can never be repeated. And for us, the Lord has given us an opportunity to go to school. If the Lord has chosen me for that season and has called me, because all the children of the men and women that walked with my father, very few saw me. They cannot actually believe. Even the time I was asked, who am I to do something for someone? Can't they do it for themselves? I was like, whoa, I thought we were family. It is because the devil decided to sit somewhere. Now, Kwama, parents, be very careful the seeds you sow when you're moving into ministry. Now, let me help the young Joshua. Some of you are parents. Never open your mouth and say anything that is not right about your fellow ministers. You are sowing a seed for your children. I sat like this and I saw all the seeds that were planted when we were babies by our parents about one another. And us, we are paying for them. Because when I say I am, when you tell me we are family, I was like, yeah, right. That is why I decided to, when I was kicked out, I'm like, Esther, you don't belong here. This year I asked the Lord in April, why am I being boxed east, right, left and center? Even where I would run to as church, the boxing is too much. From parents and their children? I'm like, Lord, what is going on? Then the Lord is like, Esther, you love fixing yourself. I'm like, oh! I wanted to be like them. When the Lord puts a mark on you like this, stop fixing yourself. I am helping the young Joshuas because people kept quiet and wrong things were said and they were not corrected. And it was a seed that flourished in some people's lives and it gave fruits and most of them are eating the fruits. You just see it in their character. And I'm like, oh, Bambi, they don't know. And what is unfortunate, the Lord speaks and he has not spoken to you yet that the mistake you made them days. That is why when we go for repentance, you confess your sins of your forefathers and your mothers, whether you were there or not there, and your fathers. Deliverance. attempt to get a deliverance. That is why you're like, if you're to be naked. Esther 4:14 is waiting for every man and woman who knows the truth and has certain it. Discipline tukamba yambe kwenga mwete mwagala kwe yamba. Muti ya avantu. Umana omu ntu echinene nye chainzo kukulela kwe kuzika. Na atakuleka kunguru kuhunye. Na akutuwala mtu. They take you to your village. Because that is the only time you cannot take yourself anywhere. They carry you to your village. Then they dig that hole. Then they buy for you a coffin. I know. When I'm thrown out, the things people have done, I was like, Ya Rabbi. I want the young Joshuas to learn and pick his. I tell you who are put in a position of authority, please, first get off your high horse. Let us do things right. Because most of you have big followings. Whenever you stand and speak like this, because you have your anger, your rage, all you bring out. Everyone who has gone to a church where your pastors, your apostles, your bishops, they are part of life, is pointing fingers and blaming the old people for their mistakes. And you sit there and you're like, yes, Magandeka, yes. Let me tell you something. When that man and woman released a word, they released a demon, and you have it, and you carry it along with you. Find out. It is time to check yourself. When someone is preaching like this, be very careful. You do like this. Make sure you see in the spirit, because as they speak like this, the bullets of hatred and other things are coming out. And when you do like this, yay, Amina, yay, you receive good. You can only know that if you walk in the Spirit. Continue and finish. That is why most of you are behaving like that, because of the men and women you honor. You call it honor. But the honoring, you don't know what it means. You're like Manoah. Let's continue. Those are characters in the Bibles and all of us. And be careful with your names. Everyone's name, someone did something wrong. You have a positive and negative, and some of you took the negative part of the names in the Bibles. Be careful. Sarah played the blame game, yet she was a chosen woman to give birth to the promised child. Rebecca, did not tell her husband the truth, what the Lord had said. Rachel stole her father's goods. She was the chosen woman, and most of you took the Rachel side. Rachel died. Because Jacob said they released a word when Laban chased them and told them they had stolen his goods. And he told them, Jacob, the husband, mama, if you're Rachel, this is the time that the Lord has made. And you sit down and ask the Lord. Because you only have the positive side of the name. You don't have the negative side. Discipline. Rachel made... made her husband stay in the house for 21 years. Remember, Jacob had to work for 7 years. Discipline is very important. That jealousy lifestyle is not taking you anywhere. And most of you, the Rachels, check yourself. I am sorry, but it is what it is. When we go to Moses, you're called Moses. Please check your, those are characters in the Bible, and you carry the names. Abraham, hello. Paul. Rebecca. You have a name from the Bible. Happy birthday, Queen Ruth. Hey, this is it. Continue discipline and disciples. Hey, you have a name for the Bible? And some of you hijack names and you call yourself Esther. She was a slave girl who was hidden. It is all I've seen in my life. Until the Lord is like, I want the purpose as to why I created you. It did not stay in the Bible. I carry it around. Now, when you're hijacking names from the Bible, be very careful. You called Samson out there? Careful. You called Jonathan out there? Careful. You called David. You know your parents. You sit there and name the child. They come with a character from the Bible. It all starts in the spirit. Continue discipline. We will continue with the character. And you don't want to go for never give up. The names you carry come with a positive and negative. The biggest characters for the season is Jacob and his entire family. Now, if your one name follows Zander, careful. You're called Judah. You're called Reuben. You're called Dan. You're called Benjamin. You're called Joseph. Naphtali. Levi, the Leviticus. Diana. Ephraim, Manasseh. And guess what? Most of the other characters after the book of Genesis fall under the 14 tribes of Israel. The first 12 are the children of Israel. The next 2 are grandchildren of Israel. Now, check yourself proper as you're reading that Bible. Those who don't have the name from the Bible, when the Lord chose you or called you, he gave you a particular character through the anointing you carry. Continue. This is a month of discipleship, October. Most of you don't want to go and be discipled. You're like, I can also teach. I look at you and when I look, Mwakuba Dr. Serwada. He who laughs last laughs best. Tamala want COVID yaja. You guys be very careful. This is Bible that Dr. Serwada you seeing. He's a man. If he made mistakes, he made mistakes, yes. But he's a man that carries the presence of the Holy Ghost. You did not know. You are a human being. In COVID-19, I've seen all your nakedness. I know what good and bad you can do. Me, I'm the type who works with people. And I make it my personal business when you are my friend. When you are my family members. I know weaknesses of my family members. I know weaknesses of my friends. Because I'm the type, I see beyond my nose. I look at you. You think we are seated here and just jazzing. I am listening to how you present yourself, how you shout, how you think you know a lot. Funny enough, people who say that I talk a lot, when I look at them, I laugh my head off. I know whether you are my mother, whether you are my father, whether you're my grandfather, whether you're my auntie, whether you're my pastor, I know. It is the Lord and the scripture, not me. The final verse, discipline is key. Most of you don't respect one another because people don't have titles. You don't see any qualification. That's what man's idea is all about. That is why the Lord put there the EMP, the people you honor. As in for you, you respect those men. The people you don't honor, when they speak, you don't listen. But if Pastor Robert is to say a word, all of you just fall and bend. When Apostle Bunjo says a word, those who know him bend. Those who know Kansanga, they bend. Those who know Apostle Chimuli bend. Those who know Pastor Tom bend. Those who know Pastor Ben Ochola bend. Hey, happy birthday, Ruthie, the Queen Yahasirif. Those who know Pastor Namteri bend. Those who know you have your people you honor. Those who know Pastor Moses Mukisa, he's an apostle. They bend. Those who know Pastor Ruwama James bend.
Those who know Pastor Chintz, bend.
But now, you who has no qualification. First of all, we heard about your story. You never graduated. Everyone is rejecting you. You have a lot of problems. How are we going to respect you, Mazim?
Because that is the man's idea. When Pastor Robert has just started ministry,
many them now believe in him. You've never heard of the story. When he said he's going to build that big church, people questioned it. People never chiwunzika, never chichusa, never chivururane.
Right now they sit and they're like, Kalomtaja ya gamba. And he stood his ground because he knew who had called him. Don't joke around. When the Lord told Apostle Bunjo, you have to go, some friends looked at him and they were like, Nae Bunjo, Olikech Cham. And when he agrees with the wife, two are better than one.
When Apostle Bunjo's wife speaks, Apostle Bunjo does not look left, right, and center and calls, I'm not at my brother, Chimuli. Now the wife says, huh?
When she says, because he knows that the wife is a special breed in the things of God. She is special. I've seen pictures of weddings. I don't see her there. Then when they were doing Thanksgiving, Apostle Bunjo said most of the times they don't carry her around because of the presence she comes with, and she sees beyond her nose.
When you want to walk with me,
when I go somewhere, I start asking myself, why? Why that one? When I came to the U.S. and I started moving around, the yard wasn't working. I saw poles which look like a circumcised man. And I'm like, you are everywhere. When you go to Maryland, D.C., Virginia, why?
Other people have never bothered to ask themselves why. Then the Lord had sent me to the U.S. with a book. When I wrote that book, I got my answers deeper.
And I'm like, I told it.
Continue and finish.
Discipline. Which kind of disciple are you? Are you the disciple who only listens to your pastor because you honor your pastor? Because he's the one you know? Because he's the one you see? When you don't see other people, they are not important. I told you, I don't know why the Lord decided to use me as the biggest example that is ever, ever there.
I also don't know.
If you want to know that answer, go and attend Dr. Mulinde's classes. He told us to pray for the United States of America. Please. Because the United States of America is going through a very, very, very tough time. We have not yet seen, we are yet to see more. But let me tell you something. The state I'm in, the city I stay in, there is no chaos. Ask why. There is a time it rained so bad, cats and dogs. People lost power. I stay 5 minutes away from my work. Even now, I stay 5 minutes away from work. I switched location. I reached at work and the power had chucked. They had over, and that day they changed my time for work. A person is supposed to start at 7 or 5 or 6. I started at 8 p.m. And they had to move things for 3 hours. I got to work and everyone was very annoyed. And me, I was very flesh. And I did not understand what they said the power chucked. Even the standby generators at some point failed. And me, I was like, power chucked away here. I am 5 minutes away, did not see power chuck. What happened? It was raining cats and dogs and I was in my bed. Because I did my watch parties for the different services, then I laid there to rest because I was supposed to go to work. People have, when it rains so bad, some states are affected so bad. But the state I stay in, the area I stay in,
we are continuing with the Nazarites. You're going to find out if you're called or not, so that you learn how to sort your life out. Let us finish. our main celebrant, verse 17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, that is grafted in. Mubere ni mgamanze na loko kanze. When I look at you, your character is saying something else. Those who have, unfortunately or fortunate, Pastor Robert is the biggest, big example we have in the country. That is why I don't bring Billy Graham. And her daughter prayed yesterday, the other day. That is the daughter who used to read for Billy Graham the Bible when he could not read. And I was surprised that she's not the president. Because she is her father. Exactly. Her father never had a side when he was a presidential advisor on the side of God. I was so surprised that they did not give it to her. They gave it to somebody. That is how God hides his people. Because when she stands, God just moves, unlike other children. Now you check yourself. Continue. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, open. Your Bible does not have the amplified part. The other Bible says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Joel, you are kidding us. I'm sorry, it is what it is. But you are taking us further because I know the Lord speaks different to an apostle. You are an apostle. Me, I'm just here for devotions. Hiya, boss. Hey, continue our main celebrant and I leave. I'm left with only 10 minutes. Okay. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, open a bracket. That is grafted. Do you know grafting? Do you know what grafting is? Those who do art. Do you know what grafting is? You're carrying the Bible names. Do you know what grafting is? They grafted you. And the name comes with all the qualities it has in the Bible. So be careful, my friends. Be very careful. You're called Leah? Enjoy the classes. It is time to go back to the basics. You carry the name, but you need to pray for yourselves on a big scale. That is why some of you hijack other people's names and you carry their names. Now, girls who are getting married, it is time to start praying for that man's name. Because... yes. Hey, mama. Mwere yo. Nemwere gala ganze. Nimchala wagu. Ndiyo mwere ati nemba tunulia. Nemba sasira. Nengamba. Nga weti seke jenge. Noli sobola. Bondages in my father's house. That name came with bondage. Ya mwamiani? Oh, tewaba amina. Teba na like. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, that is grafted in, joined to him by faith in him as a savior. A savior. Close the bracket. He is a new creature. Open bracket. Reborn and renewed by the Holy Spirit. Close the bracket. The old things. The previous moral and spiritual condition, close the bracket, have passed away. Beloved, behold, comma, new things have come because spiritual awakening brings a new life. Verse 18, but all these things are from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ. Jesus became the bridge. He bridged the gap. And now you have to walk from this side to this side because the gap was bridged. Before Jesus came and it was only the law, there was a space. And you had to work so hard. Get come, kukuru, those birds. Now when I look at Uganda, you have, over where would you have got come, kukuru? You, some of you don't even know how to separate animals that don't have... what do they call it? The chewing card. You know those funny things about... Did you read Leviticus? Did you read Deuteronomy Numbers? Have you read those books very, very well? Oh, your church reads only the New Testament because of the breath. Moved. Jesus became the bridge and he bridged the gap. Now man moves from sin and goes and works. And what is so funny, because of the bridge, you keep going back and forth. And you're like, because feel at home in a church. So you just do all the rubbish because you are at home. When you go to a particular home and you find their children there, they don't even greet you. They say, hello. And they look at you from head to toe and walk away. Who is that? Mommy's relative. Aunt Teva Gwakujan. What's up? It is our role. What time? Verse 18. But all these things are from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ, making an acceptable to him, and gave us the ministry of reconciliation, so that by any example we might bring others to him. That is God. That is, the God was in Christ, reconciling the world to himself, not counting people's sins against them, but canceling them. And he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. That is restoration to favor with God. So we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God were making his appeal through us. We, as Christ's representatives, plead with you on behalf of Christ to be reconciled to God. He made Christ, who knew no sin, to judicially by sin on our behalf, so that in him we would become the righteousness of God. Righteousness of God. That is, we would be made acceptable to him and placed in a right relationship with him by his gracious, loving kindness. I will stop there. I don't have time. You need to do a Bible study. Most of you stop on verse 17. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, and you don't even know how to quote it, he is a new creature. All of these things are gone, Pastor. But every day when you get out of church like this, the old man is waiting for you. I don't know. Your old self just comes back. When you leave church, you know, when you're in church, we are holy of holies. Pastor Lubama said he's with Nangabo Christ Miracle Center, Miracle Christian Fellowship. He stays in Nangabo. He said, if you want to know someone who is saved, find them at home. I have seen people in their homes. Ouch. Ah, the maids have seen you. They know you. The maids you carry around, they know who you are. Now me, how I know who you are, I've taken time to study you. When the anointing leaves, when the Holy Ghost leaves like this, I know who you are. Unfortunately, you've never hid from me. You hide from other people who don't know you. But with Esther, I know deeper than you think. Okay. Some people want a religion that suits their personal lifestyle. They seek a church that places few demands on them. Unfortunately, they never experience the power of a living faith. This is the owner of the book known to me. If the challenge to discipleship is to be truly effective, it must influence every facet of your life. This means that you have to admit your weaknesses, confess the sins and failures of your past, and recognize your dependency on God. When you feel that you cannot live up to the standards of the Lord, and it seems as if your spiritual life is falling apart, share your unhappy circumstances with God and ask for his help. No one has ever asked Jesus for help in vain. When you accept Jesus' assistance, you also accept the responsibilities of willing discipleship and discipline. Your mind and spirit should be brought under the dominion of the Holy Spirit. In this way, your thoughts become constructive and your character strong so that you can do the will of God and become a disciple who is worthy of your calling. I thank you, merciful Master, for the strength and that you give me through your Holy Spirit so that I can live my life in the way that you expect of me. Amen. Now, you are a leader. Time to check yourself what kind of life you're living. Because your life you live privately influences people in the spirit. The devil hijacks it, and for you think that is private. You have a company, you have a project, you have a business. How do you run your business and how do you run God's business? You're the same person doing all of that. You are a servant of the Most High God, as you call it. You're into politics. How do you make your political life and your run? Before I close, let me read for you something very interesting here. Also, the first time I met Ruth Bader, those who don't know Ruth, is that fallen general. Hid. This was Bill Clinton talking about her. On a Sunday evening in June of 1993, when she came to see me at the White House residence, she was on a final list of three people I was considering for an appointment to the Supreme Court, all of whom were excellent candidates. You were an excellent candidate, but what makes you stand out? I knew this was one of the most important decisions I would make in my presidency, and I had reviewed dozens of candidates and carefully studied their records. Your records before you become something. I don't have time, unfortunately, but we will cover it again tomorrow. Let's put a full stop there. I never want to get to work late too. I cannot teach about time management for the things of God, and I fail on earth. The world, the spiritual influences the earth. You have to walk the talk. Most of you have taught us things, but when you come out and walk like this, I see the opposite of what you're teaching us. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for this time. I thank you for your word. Give us the spirit of understanding. Help us check ourselves, including me, our discipline as disciples. Because we are all disciples of Jesus, all of us. But how do we walk while saying we are representing Christ? I plead the blood of Jesus over each and everyone who came live, who will come later, 20, 30 years from now, till Jesus comes back. Lord, intervene and take over. I pray for the EMP. Anoint them more. Let the Holy Spirit run with them as they teach your people in COVID-19. Because we want all of us. It's only 70 that has to get out and go to church. But the 30 is still behind to make 100. Holy Spirit, that means the 70 need to be very prepared for what's ahead of us and take us to the place where the Lord wants us to go. I give you praise, I give you glory. Enlarge their camps and territories. Uganda, I hide you deeper in the Lord because you are the pearl of Africa. You have the light. Africa has to get out of the dark continent part of the story because Uganda has the light and it is the pearl of Africa. I give you praise, I give you glory. And Father, the U.S. needs you more than ever before. Intervene in our situation. Thank you, my God. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name, I believe and pray. Amen. I'm always humbled when you put your data and sit there and look at me. Sometimes I know there are people who don't understand. They are like, what is she talking about? But the Holy Spirit will interpret more his word. I'm just a vessel. See you around. Please attend everything. Today is a Friday. It is very, very special. Happy birthday to all those that made it, represented by Queen herself, Queen, the lawyer, Ruth Twandwe.